motion near your patient. Patient must see that you can prepare him. Yes? After that, if they're talking about percussion, you should cut your nails. That's why next class. I will cut your nails? No. I don't give you one. Because today I saw already. Oh, nails. That's great if you want to. I don't know. To do massage for your patient or something, but for percussion you should cut your nails because it's possible to kill the patient if you have 2 kilometers nail. Now, technique of percussion. It's a turn. That's good. Position of your hand. You put, first of all, you're walking with dominant hand. If you're left handed, you will percuss with left hand. If you're right handed, right hand. After that, you put your hand on the chest, patient chest. We are talking about lung percussion. We have two types of percussion, comparative and topographic. Comparative, you'll compare the symmetrical areas. Topographic, you'll check borders of the lungs. Comparative percussion is loud percussion. Why? You want to go deeper to the tissues, 5 to 7 centimeters. That's why it's loud. If we're talking about topographic, borders are staying light superficially. That's why percussion will be quiet, not so loud. Now, you put your hand in the intercostal space. You'll use middle finger, you press the finger. Here should be space to reduce spreading of the sound, to accumulate the sound. And after that, you use middle finger of the broken walking hand, and you will use middle part of this middle finger. Your position is like 90 degree vertical position, position of your femur, yes? Your hand, your wrist is working like badminton. Not tennis, not shoulder, but wrist is working. And after that, 2 to 3 times, not more than, not less than, to characterize the sound. Now you can compare sound. You see differences? It looks like this one, but not clear. Now, resonant sound, long, low pitched, and loud. Dull sound, quiet, high pitched, and short. Boom. Timpanic. Loud, low pitched, and long. Yes, but loudness is maybe not same for resonant. And pitched, not so clear, not same, yes? For resonant of instant. Now, comparative percussion. Clear? If you are talking about comparative percussion, we will use lines for percussion. Lines. All the lines. For parasternal in midclavicular line, we have spatial rules. For parasternal, you can compare first and second intercostal space, and that's all. For midclavicular, first, second, and third, and that's all, because here is hot medium. Okay? That's why, let's start. I will show you. Parasternal. Not my position. Suprascapular, up to that. Scapulars, without extra finger. First intercostal, second, and after that, only one side. Resonant, what does it mean? That's border. That's all. And after that characteristic, the sound on symmetrical areas is resonant. Midclavicular. Second. Third. And one side. Decreased resonant, that's all. Resonant sound, symmetrical areas. After that, same for anterior axillary, same. Mid axillary, spatial position of your hand, hands up. If you're talking about axillary area, first position will be vertical because it's not possible to press your finger. That's why first vertical and after that, horizontal. Clear? Okay. You see, doctor is staying near the patient. Don't walk here. You should stay. If you are left-handed, that's left part of the left side of the patient. If you're right-handed, right, but you cannot walk. That's why position, and after that percussion. Only hands are walking. Clear? Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, scapular line. You cannot percuss scapulars. That's why suprascapular area. And after that, cross your hands. For me, this sound was not proper sound. Why? It's too high for me. It should be level of the chest. That's why it's possible to use chair for patient.
Mm.
Because it should be like this. Clear? So for me, that's not resonant. Near the scapula, but not scapula. And after that, horizontal. Clear? And after that, last line parameter. That's all for comparative.